The Life of Caius. Caius is one of the three ancient leaders of the Volturi, who are based in Volterra, Italy, and who, according to Edward Cullen, lead a very civilized lifestyle. Caius has a wife named Athenodora, and is the most ruthless of the three leaders. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Caius. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Caius was born around 1300 BC and at some point became a vampire. He was born at least a century before Ero and was transformed into a vampire in his late 40s. He met Athenodora after running afoul in the Romanian coven, and they began traveling together as a bonded pair, with her later becoming his wife. When they came across Ero, he was quite taken of the vampire's ambitious and long-range plans of domination. By the time they met, Ero had already formed the Volturi coven with a talented young vampire named Marcus. Caius was immediately attracted to the idea of joining forces with the gifted vampires. Though Caius had no psychic gift, Ero was drawn to his ambition and passionate capacity to hate, which was a great potential for manipulation and what could be both a weakness and a strength. Ero's sister Didymi joined them quickly afterwards, and later Ero's wife, Sulpicia. Ero and Caius were both in agreement that the wives must be protected at all costs after seeing that Didymi's death had devastated Marcus. By bringing more vampires into the Volturi as subordinates, they brought about his ultimate goal, a war against the Romanian coven. After the Romanians were mostly destroyed, Caius became satisfied to spend his time punishing offenders of Ero's laws. However, his satisfaction partly came from Chelsea's influence that kept him loyal to Ero, and therefore he never considered taking all the power for himself. Some 2,000 years before Breaking Dawn, he was nearly killed in a fight with a werewolf, which prompted him to hunt them to near extinction. He also took part in the extermination of the immortal children and cleaning up after the Southern Vampire Wars, making sure that newborn armies and their creators were destroyed. But when he felt bored, he would have Corin use her power to make him happy. Twilight. While not making an appearance, Caius is mentioned by Edward when he shows Bella a portrait of Carlyle with the Volturi leaders. New Moon.
She knows too much. She's a liability.
Caius makes his first appearance in New Moon. He is insistent that Bella not be allowed to leave Volterra alive. When it is determined that the Cullens will change her, Ero assures him that they should let her leave. In truth, Ero is hoping to persuade them to join the Volturi. Even though she is allowed to leave, Caius is of the opinion she had to be killed, but does nothing to persuade Ero's mind. When the Cullens leave, he warns them to change her soon, because the Volturi don't give second chances. In the movie adaptation of New Moon, Caius remains mostly in the background, observing Bella's immunity to Ero and Jane's powers, confirming that she is a liability due to her knowledge of vampires, Edward's attempt to protect her from Felix, and later advises the Cullens to turn her before they send a portion of their guard after her. Eclipse. Caius makes no appearance in Eclipse, but he is mentioned when Jane expresses his interest in Bella still being human, only to be countered by Alice Cullen's words, "The date is set." In the film, it is Bella who says it. Alice also mentions that Caius has the resources to send an unfamiliar face, meaning he has many servants at his disposal. Breaking Dawn. In Breaking Dawn, Caius joins the rest of the Volturi on the trip to Forks caused by the supposed immortal child crisis. When they arrive, however, they find not just the Cullens defending the child, but many other vampires and a large number of Quileute shapeshifters. Ero, after learning that Renesmee is actually half-human, tries to solve the confrontation peacefully, i.e. kill the child and obtain the gifted vampires that he covets. Caius, however, is in favor of a bloodbath. To accomplish this, he stresses the fact that the Cullen's alliance with the werewolves was not something the Volturi tolerated, and the execution of Irina after her false report. During the charade of a council, he votes that Renesmee and everyone who defends her must be destroyed. However, all his efforts fail, and Ero orders the Volturi to leave peacefully once he was forced to do so in order to protect his coven. In Breaking Dawn Part 1, he appears in the post-credits scene where he hears about the Cullen's new addition and Ero's statement that the Cullens have something he wants. In Breaking Dawn Part 2, during Alice's vision of the battle, Tanya, Kate, and Garrett kill Caius to avenge Irina by ripping his head from his lower jaw, partially beheading him. Though the battle is prevented, he continues to find any possible signal to trigger it, first by telling that Renesmee is still a threat. When that fails, he points out that the Cullens have been working with werewolves, the natural enemies of vampires. His attempt to trigger the fight is thwarted by Ero's declaration that there is no danger at present. After the confrontation ended, Caius grudgingly leaves with his coven. Life and Death, Twilight Reimagined. In this alternate novella of Twilight, Caius was executed sometime after Didymi's murder. Sulpicia acquired Arrow's gift through her servant Millay, and found out that Caius was in on the plot and so executed him along with Arrow. His wife, Athenodora, then took over his leadership position of the coven. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.